available to carry you there. The first is our Highway in the Sky, Walt Disney World monorail system. The second is one of three Staten Island-style ferry boats across the Seven Seas Lagoon. Since they both take about the same amount of time for the trip, we suggest taking one on the way over. Look to our driver's right-hand side as we pass these trees. Over to your driver's right, there's a row of bushes and a white building behind us. That white building is the Walt Disney World Connector.
Time to die. Dying, dying. 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 Welcome aboard the Nautilus. We are proceeding on a course that will take us on a voyage 20,000 leagues under the sea. Our route will pass beneath the polar ice cap and then probe depths seldom seen by man. So make yourselves comfortable. But please, remain seated at all times. Here among the reefs, you will see many familiar inhabitants of the undersea world. The great green sea turtles, for instance, are the reptilian patriarchs of the deep. These amphibious descendants of the dinosaur have changed little in the past 200 million years. Groupers, or giant sea bass, roam the coastal bottoms in search of food. The giant clam, obviously, is quite safe from such marine predators. The fish world has always been considered a silent habitat, but with our sonar hydrophones, we've discovered that fish actually talk. Listen. The crew from one of our satellite ships. They are harvesting the abundance that nature has sown here beneath the sea. Kelp beds are cultivated, sea creatures corralled and protected from predators, just as terrestrial shepherds protect their flocks from ravenous wolves. Weather alert, all controls 8 degrees down. Hold her at 80 fathoms and proceed on course. The Nautilus can dive safely below the violence of ocean storms. Surface vessels are not so fortunate. Witness the evidence of their fate.
You'll believe
a kingdom filled with magic.
I have got news this here, keelboat stuff. Uh-oh, folks, I don't have to tell you this, but I have to tell you now. We have a small leak in this boat. Yeah, it's down in that center cabin. They're probably getting a few little wet right now. But don't worry, folks, I figure we should be a jamboree. I think it's kind of dumb, though. Who ever heard of a guitar strumming bear singing Davy Crockett? I guess here on the frontier, we can't be too choosy. And up ahead is raft landing. And if y'all want to see Tom Sawyer's Island, you need to take those rafts to get there. Hey, do y'all want to play chicken with that raft up there? I might win.
Go for it.
But don't you feel sorry for those folks, though? Look at the accommodations they have put up with. Just think, you guys have cabins with water, well, be real careful. They are man-eaters. Now, that doesn't mean you women and children. To the left of the windmill, which is over there on our right, is the entrance to Injun Joe's Cave. Now that cave is checked for catacombs and entwining pathways. A lot of folks I know have gone in, but they've never found their way back out. So if you have a kid, wait, train ride through the Old West during the gold mining days.
What's in that house? That's
a mountain.
Uh-oh, folks, sounds like the Indians have taken over the fort up there, and they're wooden Indians, and they're shooting wooden bullets. If you get hit by one, I'm going to have to give you a wooden Band-Aid. Now, wouldn't I? Uh-oh, look yonder there. Looks like the Dreaded River Pirates struck again. I sure hope those homesteaders got out all right. But I'll tell you one thing, though, they're flying fish. And dog deer we call Spot. We call him Spot because he's always in that same spot, day after day.
Hi. There's some Indians over here.
Over to our left, we do have a tribe of friendly Indians. Now, do you all see that squirrel underneath the canopy there? Do you know what she's making? Well, she's making tea dinners. And folks, we want to stop there, but I'm sorry, I forgot to get reservations. Good. Uh-oh, folks, you hear that ruckus up ahead there? That's the Dreaded River Pirates. And we call it Pirate Cove. Let's all be real quiet. Don't move, don't talk, don't even breathe. I might still get by here safely.
And we enter the Amazon River. Just that, on your right and left, you'll see large, beautiful butterflies. These butterflies are known to have wingspans ranging anywhere from 12 inches all the way up to 1 foot. And this lush vegetation you see growing all around the center. Well, this lush grows absolutely with no soil, no moisture, or sunlight. That's because it's of the rare species known as polyurethane. In other words, the glass goon. Folks, just ahead as we round the next bend, you'll see beautiful Inspiration Falls. We call it Inspiration Falls because it is known to inspire us to go deeper into the jungle. Now let's just pause for 1 second and be inspired. That's long enough. Folks, as we round the next bend, we will be on the Congo River with its many carnivorous vines. As a matter of fact, one of these vines reached into my boat just last week. I pulled the lady out from wherever you're sitting at. You might want to hang onto the boat. Or you might want to get pulled out of the boat. Okay, folks, just ahead. On the right, you will see three pygmy war canoes. Each one of these canoes is known to contain 300 pygmies. That's right, these are 900 of those guys out there just waiting to attack this boat. Have no fear, though, if they do attack, it will only be a short attack. No? Okay. Just ahead, on the left, you'll see the giant python. You gotta watch out, because this guy's known to reach into the boat and have a crush on someone in just about 3 seconds. As we round the next bend, we'll see the remains of a safari camp with a few uninvited guests. Looks like they did a really nice job of parking that Jeep. Folks, just a word of warning to anyone wearing yellow. Please don't make any noises like a banana. Okay, they find that very appealing. As we round the next bend, we'll be on the Nile River. Straight ahead, we see the sloping forehead, massive ears of the African bull elephant, the largest living land mammal today. As large as he is, there is still only one thing in the world he's afraid of, and there she is, folks, his mother-in-law. Louder, please. on the next bend. Up ahead on your left, you will see a rock. And down this rock stands Trader Sam. Trader Sam just recently got a promotion. He's been promoted to head salesman of the jungle. And he's got a top-notch deal for you people today. He's willing to trade three of his heads for only one of yours. Any takers? Folks are bound to come out a head or two. Well, folks, now for the most dangerous part of the trip, aside from my jokes. My attempt to try to dock the boat. Up on the dock, you will see two more rare forms of chops and plant legs.
not make yourself full.
Oh, of course. Watch your manners.
Yeah, if you can't say something nice.
Boys, okay now, boys, if you just stop carrying on like.
We just might dedicate this next song to y'all. And be so dedicated.